Okay, so today this is the Wonder Bracelet's test number 2. You can see I'm on the floor. That's the carpet. I put this here just in case I burn the house down. Okay, that's just my lighter. And I actually have 6 of these. Actually, sorry, 9 of these. Just so that way you can't say that I am cheating with the magnets. Okay? I zoom it in so you can see. As long as you see them moving, they all pointing south, as you can see. Let me zoom in. Hopefully the camera will focus. Nope. Zoom in too close, it won't focus. You can see south is all up here. Okay? East is that way. I lined them as much as I could east. That's south. And this is north. And this over here is west. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to twist it a little bit so I can film this way. I'm going to heat this up. This is the one that I test in my previous video. Okay? This is regular without, and I'm going to show it to you. All of them. See if they would move. Okay? Nobody's moving. Because they're all cold right now. I can't get any closer than that because you saw what happened. If I go too close, you won't be able to see. Let me go just a little bit. Let's see. There we go. I probably get away with that. Nothing's moving. Okay? All of them. All of them pointing the same way. That way. That's east. Okay? Now, I'm going to pan over here. And we're going to heat this up. Let me push this aside because I don't want to touch that. As I stated, this is just one piece of metal. Okay, there's nothing underneath there. I put that metal there because I don't want to burn the house down. Ha ha. My grandmother would kill me. Okay. Gonna heat this up. And I'm going to use a plier just to hold on to them. This time, I'm just going to heat up the thing too. Okay, that should be enough. As soon as you see them clear, see? That's hot enough. Now let's go back over here. See them moving? See them moving? Right there? This one? That one's moving? This one? See now they are moving? Okay, put it in the center and move up. See? They're moving. Whoop, sorry. I touched that one. There you go. Losing heat. Let me heat it up some more. I'll hold it up here. Oop, out of camera there. I'm gonna burn the house down. Okay. Moving. This one moving. These are moving. This one's moving. Oh, sorry. Touch that one. Yeah. This one moving. This one close here. This one's probably good in the camera. See? It's moving. Okay. Moving. Moving. And this one probably can't see in the camera, but it's moved a little bit. This one moving a little bit. Okay. Now they all stopped. I'm going to heat it again. Let's try the one without heating. This one. Oop, let me put my hand out of the way. Moving. Nobody's moving. Okay. I just run up and down like this. See? Nobody's moving. Oops, sorry, Benny. My dog. Anytime I heat up some stuff, especially gas. Okay, let's heat it up really good this time. Third test. This one's a lot, okay? There you go. Moving. Ooh, look at this one. Look at this one. This one, I have to leave it up here for it to move. There you go. You move. Wait! Push that back a little bit. And you notice I've spaced them apart so they don't affect each other. Oh, I just touched that one. Okay. Okay. Let me heat up some more. One more time. I'll leave it a little longer. This is actually in a really high scale. I don't know. If from your battery, if I have to guess on this, it's probably 2,000 times the amount of your own battery. I just heat it up really hot. You see it? You saw a glow. It's going to affect a lot, this one. See it? See it? In the middle here. Okay. I heat up this up a little longer so you can see all of them moving. Ooh, just hit that one. You have to go from here to here. Ooh, just hit that one. You have to go to here because north and south will end up this way. Positive and negative will be ending up that way. And that's why it moves that way. Okay? And that's it. And I'm going to let this cool over here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use the one that is not heating up, and I'll show it to you. Ow! Ooh! I just touched that one. Let me move this away. Ooh, that one's hot. Alright. Let me move that back before I do this. Let me adjust the camera really nicer. Okay? Do they move? No. No, because they're cool. Oh, I just touched that one. This one I touched. Need to be a little farther away so I don't touch it. Okay. No movement. Okay, Now, here's another one, my old one. This is probably like my fifth or sixth. Yep, I made that long ago, and you can tell. You can tell by the copper. It faded away. Oh, how do you clean this? Alcohol. Or acetone. Let's try that. Nobody's moving. Okay. Let me move that one low a little bit. I'm gonna heat this one up too. One last one. I'm gonna heat this up. Let me hold it with the heating. I don't really want to touch it. Uh-oh. I'm starting to be smelly. My dog's gonna start thing pretty soon. Uh-oh. This doesn't affect it. Oh. That one's not touching. It broke. This is the broken one, so I just left it. Let me see if I'd be able to push this in a little bit. Let me hold that. Oh, there we go. See, there was a broken piece right here. Now it'll work. See? Because it's touched. That one was broken too, but I pushed it together. So you gotta hold it like right there. You have to remember, negative and positive have to be together, okay? Look at this one. Oh my god. See how powerful that one is? This one. Look. See how powerful it is? Okay. They are moving. See? This one's really strong because you see how many coil that is? The more the coil, the stronger it is. And the reason why that is that this was my third or fourth that I made, and it was just too long. So I wear it because I clamped it and it broke right there, but now I know how to fix it too. Comparing to this coil, see. This is actually better. Because you don't want to take too much out of your body. Remember, you can only take a certain amount. Let me heat it one more time. I will do a how-to later, do's and don'ts with these bracelets. You have to remember, you want to remove the extra electrons only. You do not want to remove anything further than that. Because remember I told you in plenty of the video, I said that we need positive and negative ions in our body. In order for our body to function correctly, we need them. So by understanding that, I am able to tell you certain things. So I'm going to do a do's and don'ts. Because you cannot just go and wear them all the time. That's why I said be aware. Don't wear them all the time. Oh my, this is going to be really strong. Oopsie. Look at them all moving. Okay. I think that's enough testing. It affects even more when you leave them on top, see? When you put them on top like that, see? See? Because there's a magnet in here in the compass. And you're disturbing the magnetic field. Because this becomes magnetic fields. And like I stated in those videos, magnetic field is a form of radiation. And when this radiates out, it creates positive and negative. So it's actually escaping. We want these to be cool. So all the electron would travel up to here and escape. So basically, that's what it is in full scale. Like thousands of times. Ooh, I just touched that one. Sorry. Thousands of times. Because our body aren't able to put this much out. So by doing this, I'm adding more in. Like I'm adding a lot of electrons. I don't know, I would say like 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 times. So you need like 1,000 people to steal, like probably 1,000 people to make these compass moves. Yeah, if you line all the people together, you would able to make these compass moves. Ooh, right there. See? Okay. Let me cool this down over here. Ooh. Before I burn my grandmother's house down. And now I'm going to use this one. And look. I'm going to move it up and down. And nobody's moving. Okay. Okay, because it's not hot. And we want it that way. We want it to stay cool. This bracelet has to stay cool. Our body's hot. So then the electrons in our blood and skin, because that's why we're able to feel. We actually don't feel. Let's talk a little bit. We actually do not feel our skin. It is actually our electrons that actually that tells our brain where we are touching. So that's why when you have metal, touch this. But it has to be two forms of metals. Remember that. And when you do this, you're able to steal those electrons. See? As easy as that. So the electrons, when it touch your skin, the electron attach itself to these, and then it goes into a coil. Because they're forced to go into a coil, they like to travel. Electron likes to travel. They don't like to stay still. If they stay still, they fight with each other. When this happens, it goes into a coil, and then it has nowhere to go but escaping. So basically, we're using the theory, and is already proven, the theories is that the electron will stay in here. It get trapped in here, and then it leaves through radiation. Mm-hmm. Other than that, that's about it on this video. I will see you in the next video.